Son, okay, so he was working in one city and he wanted to go to his village, and this is what after 10 years he has decided to go to his village. Okay, so what is the work he was doing in the city? They take the stones and they do the carving work, right? Okay, they are called sculptures. Okay, so those kind of work he was doing in the city. So stones were taken and he used to give a shape to the stone by using the chisel and hammers. Okay, so he wanted to go to his village. So he has to get down in one bus stop and he has to walk through. To reach to his village, he has to walk for close to 5 kilometers. That is what the transport facility for his village. So he got down and he was on the way. And while walking, because continuously nobody can walk, okay. So he thought that after walking for 2 kilometers, he thought that, okay, let me take some rest. Okay, after half an hour or 1 hour, again I will start. Okay. Then he saw one beautiful stone is like lying down beside a tree. Very good structured, shaped and rounded and all. Then he was so happy, and as his profession is like this. Now you would have seen the teachers, if there is a chalk piece in the hand, they will start scribbling. Yes or no? Like that only we are spoiling our classrooms also by putting the duster on the walls. These are all habits of our teachers. Okay, so similarly, he is a sculptor. So his habit is, if he sees something stone, he will have his own chisel. Chisel means that the big nail, by using that, he will put the hammer and make a shape. Okay. So he had taken out his chisel and he has taken out his hammer and he started to give one structure to this stone. Immediately, that was a special stone, and that stone started speaking. Immediately that stone opened his mouth and told that one, please don't do me anything else. Don't harm me. Don't touch me like that. He was totally shocked. How the stone can speak like this? Okay. No, I don't want this chisel, don't put it on me. Then he was silent and surprised. He took rest. Then he started his journey. He left it, left that stone, he didn't do anything. After going for another 1.5 kilometer, he sat down under another tree. And again he saw similar kind of stone is also existing here. Then he thought, let me give a second try, whether this stone is speaking or what. Then he took a second try. That stone didn't react anything, as we could able to see the normal stone. And he, by using his sigil and hammer, he could able to give a shape of Lord Ganesha. Okay, and he was so happy, and he kept that Ganesha under the tree, and he went to his native place. He reached in his village, and he could able to see that, no, some function, some celebration is going on. People are moving from one side to another side and all, and he could able to see there is a new temple in the village, because after 10 years he has gone. Okay, all were talking, and by seeing him, people are so happy and talking each other and all, and some arrangements are going on. Then he asked, what is that you are doing? No, no, we have built a temple. Okay, and this is Lord Ganesha's temple, and we want a what? Ideal for Lord Ganesha's temple. We are planning to go to city and purchase one, because tomorrow that inauguration of the temple is there. Then he was so happy, he said, I have solved your problem. You need not have to go to city. You please go 1.5 kilometer, and there already I made one Lord Ganesha. You bring it and keep it inside the temple. Then village people were so happy. Okay. Then there was a discussion. We need another perfect size of stone to keep in front of Ganesha so that everybody will come and break the coconut. Then he said, that problem also I will solve. You pick that Ganesha, then walk for another 1.5 kilometer, one tree will be there, under that one more stone is there. You pick that one, we will keep it. Then the village people, they followed his instruction, they bought the Ganesha, they bought the stone also. So Ganesha was kept, all inauguration was done, worshipping was going on, and that stone was kept to bring and break the coconut. So who are all devotees kept? They used to break the coconut there and go and worship Lord Ganesha. Okay, this story was going on. Then one day what happened, that speaking stone was there, right? Okay, who was kept to break the coconut. That fellow asked to that another stone, who is now given the present structure of Lord Ganesha. Oh, you are a stone, I am a stone. Okay, see my fate and see your fate. Everybody is coming and bowing their head in front of you. They were worshipping you. they were offering all food to you. Everybody is coming and they are just hitting me and going. This is what my friend. Then that Lord Ganesha store, no, he answered. First that chance was given to you. If you would have tolerated the pain, you could have been worshipped today. So as you do not want to come out from your comfort zone, so throughout the life, this is what your fate is. As I tolerated the pain on that day, I have been worshipped nowadays. So my dear friends, life is something like that.